Thunder and Rockets face off in the first round, exactly how we would have scripted it if we would have written it earlier this season. Tell me who has the advantage in this matchup.
Unfortunately, it's the Houston Rockets. They're probably going to take care of the series, I would say, in six games. With the way that they play and the way the Thunder just can't defend the ball at all, especially in the perimeter, they have issues with that, especially with Houston, and they have more shooters spreading the floor. The Thunder are just so young. They're the second youngest team in the NBA. I don't know if they're ready to try and take this leap and take this step. You know, the only thing that makes me hesitant to say that Houston won't win this, you know, quicker in like five games or maybe even sweep is the fact that neither team is really going to play that much defense in this series. And that kind of opens the door for Russell Westbrook, which we've seen him take advantage of a few times this year. But I think it is Houston. With the way they're playing this year, they've got enough guys in this D'Antoni system that really thrive shooting the three. And for Oklahoma City, that's been one of their weak points this year. And it's never good to trade three-point baskets for layups. And I think that's what will end up happening in this series. And then you'll see the Rockets advance in the next round. And Oklahoma City's amazing season just, you know, will have to be about the triple doubles and not so much making a run at a championship.
But what would have to happen there for OKC to advance and win? Would it be just a cold shooting series for the Rockets?
Yeah, that would have to be a big portion of it. You'd have to be able to contain James Harden somehow. I think Russell Westbrook would have to play much better defense than what he has the entire season. That's not his forte. I mean, you look at James Harden and Russell Westbrook, and it's funny in the MVP race how, you know, a lot of people want to factor in defense, but they just can't do that with those two guys just because, you know, that's not what they do. But if somehow Westbrook's able to contain James Harden and Trevor Ariza and Eric Gordon and Lou Williams all start going cold, Sam Decker, Ryan Anderson, I start saying names and just mentioning them off, I feel like I'm making my point for Houston there. But yeah, I think Oklahoma City's going to have to find a way to really step it up defensively. And, you know, the second unit for the Thunder has been, you know, for lack of a better term, terrible this season. You know, when Westbrook's off the floor, this team just loses any will to score and any way to score. You know, the biggest threat they have offensively is Enes Kanter, who is a double-double guy and close to it, but just not able to get it done. And I just don't see a way Oklahoma City can find a way to win this series.